Now I want to talk about the police, the Davenport police, and Hempfest on Credit Island, okay? Basically, a lot of people here were there, alright? What happened at Credit Island was wrong, okay? It was totally wrong. The police searched, we estimate 50% of the vehicles going into there, okay? I don't know how many of you here were hassled, but they hassled a lot of people coming in. They had amnesty barrels, there was a heavy police presence, there was 50 police officers that they will admit to being on the site from the beginning, alright? We believe that they went there with the intent purpose of shutting us down, and they kept saying to the media afterwards, we showed them, we shut them down for good this time, they weren't supposed to be back, and now we shut them down, and they kept saying that over and over. That was their intent, was to shut us down, okay? We believe they tried in every way to provoke a riot, okay? They had double agents. There was people in the crowd with long hair, wearing a pig's face on the front of their shirt and a pig's butt on the back, running around screaming, pigs, pigs, whatever about the pigs. And then 5 minutes later, this guy is wearing a police uniform attending to an officer on the ground with a broken leg. Alright, and I might add, I was charged with breaking the officer's leg, okay? And I did not do it. I did not see it happen, but witnesses told me that I was handcuffed on the ground, face down, when it happened 10 foot away, and that two officers tripped over each other. There was too many officers there, they were tripping over each other. That is what happened at Credit Island, okay? And I don't believe that they can convict me of that charge in any way, and hopefully some of you will help make it to my court date. I don't think they have a leg to stand on. Okay, what happened? The police were using their heavy handed tactics. It was upsetting people, and they went to take a woman's purse and they're wrenching it out of her hand. Okay, and they did not have a right to take her purse, but we're trying to give this woman to give up consent to it, okay? And the thing about your rights is that if you don't assert them, you don't have them, okay? That if they will just go and get on into your car unless you tell them to stop. No, don't get in my car, okay? And if a cop asks you if he can look in your car or in your pocket, you tell him no. Just say no, okay?
Just say no.
And the thing you gotta remember here, folks, is that you don't know that somebody riding in your back seat didn't drop a seed in your car, okay? And that they'll get you for that, even though you had no idea about it. And if you had some bird seed, you're taking some canary food home to your bird, and there's hemp seed in there, and it fell on your car, you know, even though that hemp seed wasn't illegal, they're going to charge you with it, you know, and it's pretty much guilty until proven innocent. So just say no if a police officer asks to search your vehicle, alright? The thing is that sometimes they won't even ask you, they'll just go to do it, and you've got to assert your right, okay? Now the thing is, there's a fine line, because they will try to charge you with resisting arrest if you try to assert your rights, okay? This is a common occurrence. You say no, and you gotta block the door. Like, if an officer wants to come in your house, he'll walk in, and if you don't put your foot in the way in the doorway, he'll push his way in, and if you don't specifically say no, you are not allowed in, then you basically invited him in. You stood at the door and didn't stop him from coming in. You opened your door, and he came in like people normally do. That's what they're gonna say. He invited us in, okay? And if you just let him get in your car, they're gonna say that you consented. You've gotta assert your right. Now, I don't know how to draw the fine line between whether you're resisting arrest or whether you're asserting your rights, but you gotta find that fine line. And let me tell you, you're way better off if you have something in your car getting charged with resisting arrest than to not assert your right, okay? You're better off getting charged with resisting arrest, because resisting arrest is generally a $100 fine, and what is in your car could get you 20 years, and it happens all the time. So assert your rights, alright? And the thing is that this woman was asserting her right by not letting go of her purse, okay? That the police were taking it from her. They did not have grounds to just take it from her, or they would have, but they were trying to get her to give up consent, okay? And people were informing the woman, hey, you do not have to consent to a search. And she said, I know, and she held on to it, okay? And then the police officers told people that they were not allowed to cross a line, and they pointed at the ground. And so people stood there, and they told the officers, hey, you know, this is a crime. You're taking your purse. You have no right to take your purse. This is a crime, okay? And basically what happened is the police officers were intimidated, okay? And people were chanting at them. And they were outnumbered, okay? and they pushed right into the middle. This happened right in front of the microphone, okay? We didn't surround them. They went into the middle of us, okay? And people stood there and let them know that they thought that this woman's rights were being violated. But nobody in any way did I see them attack the police, okay? The police attacked us. They maced people indiscriminately. They didn't care who had anything to do with what. They didn't care if you were just walking through that park that day or fishing and wanted to see what was going on. They didn't care. They maced people indiscriminately. They chased a woman through the crowd, and it showed on the news, who had just walked by an officer, and he maces her and then chases her through the crowd, and she's screaming, "I'm looking for my baby. I'm looking for my baby." And he didn't care, okay? But as soon as they saw the cameras on him, boy, did those police officers stand up straight and chew their gum and try to keep that clean image going, because they knew that this was going to come back to haunt them. That now the cameras are rolling.
Now it is.
Okay? And I'm telling you, what happened to me was a police officer jumped out and struck me in the face while I was telling them that they were violating this woman's right, and that they slammed my friends to the ground, and they were beating another friend in the face who was holding his arms out straight, and he's can be an imposing looking dude. He weighs 280 pounds. He can't help that he looks imposing, okay? He's like 6'3", weighs 280 pounds. No matter what this guy does, he can't help but look imposing. But he stood there with his arms out, and they were jacking him in the face, and he was bleeding, and the crowd got excited, okay? If you were in a boxing match or a mallard game and you see blood, you get excited, okay? And you make some noise, wouldn't you? Wouldn't you? At a football game, at a tennis match, when John McEnroe's going off, you get excited, okay? That's what happens, all right? But nobody was striking the police, all right? And what they did was they slammed me to the ground, and they held my arm and pulled it back like this and screamed, and these are their exact words. Well, I'll spare you the obscenity. They said, "Chris," they knew me by name, they called me by name, and they said, "Chris, if you don't put your arm behind your back, I'm going to break your F-word arm," okay? That's what they said, and I was saying, I can't put my arm behind my back. They're pulling it back like this, and they're sitting on top of me, and they kept hitting my head into the ground, and I wanted so badly to be able to put my arm behind my back, but I couldn't, because he's holding it in a way that I couldn't, all right? And then, after hitting my head into the ground a couple times, and they do this, the police do this, so they can assault you in front of a group of people and make it appear as though you're resisting arrest. Then they picked me up, and they started to walk me, and an officer would shove me from the right, and then an officer would shove me from the left, and then they would slam me to the ground again. And I don't know that the officer who slammed me from the ground saw the officer on my right shove me, or the one on my left. I don't know. They were on the other side. Who knows? They swung me around. They did everything they could to make it look like I was resisting arrest. And all I did was swear at some police officers who greatly upset me. And I'm sorry, but if that is freedom of speech. And if you beat me up, I'm going to swear at you, okay? My next court date's August 21st. It should be uneventful. It's basically just a preliminary where they file motions. We're doing depositions next week. There's a lot of rumors that the officer's leg, who was broken, had injured the leg before, and it was just an old football injury that was susceptible to that kind of thing, okay? Anyway, here, folks, we're here today to let them know that you do not mace people. The problem here is, folks, the war on drugs, okay? We've asked the police to do a mission impossible, all right? We are asking way too much of them. They will never be able to stop drugs, and the lawmakers have placed them in a position of confrontation with us, okay? We don't want confrontation with the police, okay? We want them to legalize it, regulate it, and tax it, okay?